Good morning, Madam Speaker, honorable members of the House, and members of the public. A pleasant morning to everyone. Indeed, it is an alarming issue the amount of road fatalities our country experiences per year, which has caused our country to suffer enormously. Madam Speaker, there's a reason the opposition is the opposition. In 2019, the opposition allocated $38.5 billion to infrastructure, part of which was supposed to go to road building. And according to an article posted by the Guyana Times, in 2019, Guyana received a record of 124 road fatalities. Madam Speaker, 85% of road crashes affect the economically productive group of people that ages range from anywhere between 15 to 64 years, according to the World Bank Group in 2016. In accordance with the World Health Organization, road crashes are the eighth leading cause of death globally among children and young people ages between 5 to 29. This is quite alarming, since road accidents result in the reduction of population, meaning that there will be less people to develop our country's natural resources. One must understand that when road accidents occur in our country's roads, they not only devastate family and cause the lives of our beloved citizens, but they also take a massive toll on our country's resources. I must also mention that road accidents are harmful for the environment in more ways than you might think. The first and perhaps the most important reason is that they result in gas leaks, which emit harmful chemicals into the air that are toxic for most living things. Also, gas leaks can run the risk of causing a fire. One such example is of the two parked lorries and a car that went up in flames following an accident that occurred on Montrose East Coast Demerara on the 4th of November 2020. Now, think about what happens after a car accident. Most car owners involved would need to get their cars repaired. And it may not come to mind at first, but car repairs see a lot of steel and fuel being used. That is on its own a great impact on emissions being released. I'd now like to remind you that some car accidents are so traumatic and massive that they leave behind damage on our country's roads. As of last November, it was estimated that there will be a $4.3 billion excess to facilitate medical responses and to execute repairs caused by road accidents. Additionally, the equipment used to repair these roads can have a damaging effect on the environment, not to mention that roads are made of tarmac, which is on its own damaging for the environment. In the government's motion, we are suggesting a more cost-efficient approach to this problem, educating our citizens about road safety. Madam Speaker, according to an article published by the World Health Organization on the 21st of June 2021, increased average speed is directly related to a crash occurring and the severity of the consequences of that crash. Driving under the influence of alcohol or any drug substance increases the risk of a car crash that results in death or serious injury. Wearing helmets correctly can lessen the likelihood of a fatal injury by approximately 42% and head injury by 69%. Wearing a seat belt reduces the risk of death among drivers and front seat occupants by up to 40% and 25% for back seat occupants. This, Madam Speaker, is just one of the many pieces of statistical evidence that proves if our drivers and road users are just more cautious, can seriously reduce the amount of road fatalities we experience annually, since the risk of death is drastically reduced by the actions of our road users. A similar program, the White Knight program, was launched in late 2016. The subsequent year, road fatalities decreased drastically and did not go above the 37 fatalities mark while the campaign was active. In conclusion, Madam Speaker, I'm confident in this motion, and I'm certain that it will not only have a positive effect on Guyanese society, but will also help create a greener Guyana and safer roads for all Guyanese. I thank you.